guys, I am here with Sir Charles. He is a Corgi, and we're going to get him cleaned up. He's going to get a bath and blow dry and trimmed up around the edges. So let's get busy. Before I put him in the tub, I'm going to go ahead and get him brushed out pretty good. Got some mats in his pants that need to come out. He's got a lot of hair. That's a good boy. There we go. Good boy. Getting him brushed out before the bath is going to get the extra hair out and the mats out and allow my shampoo system to penetrate the coat and get him nice and clean. I'll be using a deshedding shampoo and conditioner. Sir Charles is a rescue dog, and he is a lovely dog. His pet parents really lucked out in getting a dog like him. And they want these pants trimmed up pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and do that before the bath. There's no sense in blow drying all that hair. And while we don't want to cut the coarser hair at all, I don't have a problem with trimming up the softer hair. I am using blending shears to do this. They said he gets really wet underneath when he goes out with the dew, so I'm going to get that trimmed up underneath as well. Good boy. Sweet doggy. Yes, you are. All right, that's enough of that. We'll go ahead and get him in the tub now.
Yes, I'll get you in the tub. Does that feel good? Do you feel good? Oh, you feel good. Oh, you feel good. Yes, it does.
Cute dog. All right. All right, when washing a dog like this, I do like to plug their ears with cotton. It minimizes the noise, and these big old ears, they work like a funnel and funnel water right down inside them. Come here. You're fine. And very. Face washed. I do the faces by hand. I never use the shampoo machine on the face. Has a flat spray, which is really good for these double coats. Penetrates right down to the skin. Quick work of these shedding type dogs. Double coats, that's for sure. I use short back and forth motions as I put the shampoo and conditioner on and as I rinse the dog. That lifts up and loosens shedding coat. Thank you.
Isn't he sweet?
This is a loose setting. Now we're on conditioner. As you can see, I don't skimp on products.
Do you feel good? Oh boy. Oh boy, he feels great. Oh, he's a good doggy. Yes, he's a good doggy.
This is a rinse. Thank you. Ten, 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 ten. Good boy. Now I'm going to switch to a different rinse. Just to check them all over even better. Get the head because I don't like to use that hard spray on the head. Out of the ears. Actually, he already got it out himself. Where'd it go? Use ear wash. Yeah, fine. It's all right. I know it's fine. Absolutely tells me. While it may be tempted to use the high velocity dryer in the tub, I do not, because the sound of the dryer amplifies within the steel walls of the tub, and that's harder on the dog. So I'd rather do it on the table with more open space around. So I'm just gonna towel dry them a little bit. And then I'll get him out of the tub and disinfect the tub, and we'll go dry him. You're fine. Give me a break. You're absolutely fine. Come here. Now. You're fine. Just plug in your ears. And we're gonna wrap your little head. Hear it so much.
Thank you.
It's important to dry the dog as much as possible with the high velocity dryer. This gets them, you know, ready for the fluff dryer around the head. So I'm going to use the brush and brush out the head with the dryer blowing on it. Then I'm going to leave the dryer blowing while I do his nails, and that'll help to dry his head out more. by Corgi. Yay. Go ahead and get these out of his ears. Does that feel better? Mm-hmm. That. Be nice. Thank you. I'm going to trim the pads of his feet with a 30 blade. Right on schedule. Trim the back of the hocks. Very nice. Okay. This way, buddy. Good buddy. Good buddy. Yeah, so you enjoying your spa day? Are you?
He's a good boy. Yeah. Yeah. You're just so sweet. You're just so sweet.
Alright, so we're just trimming up around all the edges. Kind of tidying him up. Making sure everything has a nice flow from front to rear. So while some people do like to do the super scissored corgi butts, I kind of like to keep a bit more of a natural look to it. I don't want it to look overly stylized. I just want him to look nice and tidy and get rid of all the extra hair that is making him not as easy to live with in the house by bringing in all that wetness and getting himself dirty. So personally, I do opt for a bit more of a natural dog. I didn't cut into any of this coarse coat on his back or up over his tail, because then it may not grow back properly. So I kept it completely in the underlying area where I trimmed, and the soft part of the pants. And I think that's a problem when you get into too much of the scissored corgi bottoms, is you have to end up cutting some of this up over the tail and into some of this black to get that look. And that's the hair that doesn't grow back quite right. So that's one of the reasons why I like to stay away from doing that.
Musical Bowie. Yeah, the myth. Yeah, the myth.
Clean up these ears. And again, this is softer hair in this area, so I don't mind trimming it. This soft, silky stuff, but I want to stay away from the coarse hair. The coarse hair is where you get into trouble. And again, I'm not trying to make it look overly scissored. I'm trying to go for a bit more of a natural flow here.
What are you doing? Did you have fun here? Huh? Did you have fun with Miss Suzanne? Did you have fun with Miss Suzanne? Oh, he's a good boy. Oh, he's a good boy. Was it fun? It was fun, wasn't it? Huh? We're gonna be best friends. Yeah, we're gonna be best friends, aren't we? Yeah, we are.
I love my job.
I do. I love my job. I think it's the best job in the whole world.
Over here.
Okay, we're done playing. Yes, don't kiss me thumb right in the ear. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, you kiss me right in the ear. Dog germs. I got dog germs.
Thank you. are one fuzzy boy. Where did you get all this hair? Where did you get all this hair, dude? I thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you don't miss my next upload. I'll see you next time, guys. Bye.